This illustration is about sliding a body on incline by a string. Here, the figure shows a body of mass m pulled by a string up the incline. The friction coefficient between body and incline is mu, and to slide the body, we are required to find the angle theta at which tension and thread will be minimum. So, in this situation, if we just have a look on free body diagram of this body, and here we can draw the FBD of mass m. And you can see the body is experiencing mg in downward direction. If this dotted line is along the length of incline, if this angle is alpha, here we can see with respect to normal, this angle is alpha. And here the component of weight is mg cos alpha. In this direction, the component of weight is mg sin alpha. And along this direction, a tension is acting at an angle theta. So, we can also resolve the components of tension, which are t cos theta. And here it is t sin theta, as well as the normal reaction on the body due to incline will be in the same direction. So, we take it plus n. Now, the body will start sliding up the incline in downward direction along with mg sin alpha mu, and the friction will also act. So, here we can write to slide the body up. We use here to slide the body up here t cos theta should be equals to the forces acting in opposite direction, which are mu n plus mg sin alpha. And also we are having in the direction perpendicular to incline n plus t sin theta is equals to mg cos alpha. So these are our equations 1 and 2. Now from equation 1, here we can see the value of t cos theta we are getting is mg sin alpha plus mu n. And the value of n we can write as mg cos alpha minus t sin theta. If we further simplify it, we'll get the value of tension on the string, which is mg. You can simplify and verify this result also. The sin alpha plus mu cos alpha divided by this will be cos theta plus mu sin theta. So, here theta is varying and the value of alpha, which is that of incline, is constant. So, here we can simply write for t to be minimum, we use dt over d theta is equals to 0. As numerator is a constant, we can differentiate this term, which is minus sin theta plus mu cos theta is equals to 0. On further simplifying, we are getting the value of theta is equals to, this gives you tan theta is mu, so theta will be tan inverse of mu. That will be the final answer for this problem. The angle at which dt by d theta is getting 0. So, here the value of tension will be minimum. Or you can further differentiate this expression and substitute theta as tan inverse of mu. So, that will give you a positive value of second derivative, that means the denominator will be maximum, and correspondingly the value of tension here will be minimum, corresponding to the second derivative of d squared t by d theta.